Here I'll discuss irrational numbers. Now what are irrational numbers? Irrational numbers are a number is called irrational if it cannot be written in the form of P by Q. Here Q does not equals to 0, PQ are integers. Now what are rational numbers? Rational numbers are those which can be written in the form of P by Q, and irrational numbers are those which are not rational, so they cannot be written in the form of P by Q. Example of irrational numbers are root 2, okay, square root of 3, pi, and some decimal expansions of this type, that is which are non-terminating and non-repeating. Okay, here sometimes you see that value of pi is written as 22/7. Now note that this is an approximate value of pi and not an exact value of pi. Okay, so pi is an irrational number. Okay, now in the following questions, find which variables are representing rational numbers and which variables are representing irrational numbers. In the first one, x square equals to 5. So x equal to square root of 5. Now square root of any prime number is irrational. So root 5 is irrational. Also square root of any non-perfect square is irrational. Okay. Second part, y square equals to 9. Y equals to 3, which is rational. Okay. Third part, z square equals to 0.04. Okay. So z equals to 0.2, which is rational. Okay. Fourth part, u square equals to 17/4. So u equals to root 17/2. Root 17 is again irrational. Okay. Now fifth part, v square equals to 3. So v equals to square root of 3, which is again irrational. Okay. Sixth part, w square equals to 27. Here w equals to 3 root 3, which is again irrational. Okay. Now t is same as z, so it is again a rational number. Now you need to find a rational number and also an irrational number lying between the following numbers. Okay. See, the first number is 0.303003000 and so on. And other one is 0.333 and so on. Now, a rational number between these two numbers will be, suppose 0.312. This is a rational number between these two numbers. Now, irrational number between these two numbers is 0.32322322 and so on. This is an irrational number between these two numbers. Okay, now give an example of each of two irrational numbers whose difference is a rational number. Yeah, now you need to find two irrational numbers whose difference becomes rational. Okay, now the two irrational numbers are, suppose, root 2 plus 1 and root 2. Now on taking their difference, root 2 plus 1 minus root 2, their difference is 1, which is a rational number. Now in second part, you are asked two irrational numbers whose difference is irrational. Okay, so you can take 4 root 3 and 3 root 3. Now difference of 4 root 3 and 3 root 3 is square root of 3. Now you have to find two irrational numbers whose sum is a rational number. Okay, so root 2 and minus root 2. These are two irrational numbers whose sum is 0 and 0 is rational. Okay. Now, find two irrational numbers whose sum is also irrational. So, 2 root 5 and 4 root 5. Sum of 2 root 5 and 4 root 5 is 6 root 5, which is irrational. Okay. Now, find two irrational numbers whose product is rational. Okay. So, root 2 and 2 root 2. On multiplying, the product will be 4, which is rational. Now, when product is irrational, so you can take root 2 and root 3. Their product is root 6. So root 2 and root 3. Now, two irrational numbers whose quotient is rational. Simply 2 root 2 and root 2. Because 2 root 2 divided by root 2 equals to 2, which is a rational number. Now, whose quotient is irrational? So root 2 and root 3. Because root 2 divided by root 3 is an irrational number. Okay. Now, another concept here is locate root 3 on the number line. Okay. So, first of all, you need to draw a number line. Okay. This is suppose a number line. This is 0, minus 1, okay, minus 2. This is 1, this is 2. Now, for representing square root of 3 on the number line, we first need to represent root 2. For this, take OA equals to 1 unit. Take OA equals to 1 unit. Now, construct AB equals to 1 unit perpendicular to OA. Okay? Now, you need to construct AB equals to 1 unit perpendicular to OE. So, this is AB. This is also 1 unit. This is also 1 unit. Next is join OB. Okay. Join OB. Now, perpendicular AB can be drawn using protractor or compass. Okay. This is 90 degree angle. Now, using Pythagoras theorem, here OA is 1 unit, AB is 1 unit. So, according to PGT, OB square equals to OA square plus AB square. So OB square equals to 1 square plus 1 square equals to 2. So value of OB equals to square root of 2. Now, if we need to represent square root of 2 on the number line, then take a compass. Okay. Now, take a compass with center at O and radius equals to OB. Draw an arc intersecting the number line, suppose at a point P. Now, this point P will represent root 2 on the number line. Okay. Now, for representing square root of 3, draw BD perpendicular to OB. Draw BD perpendicular to OB and length of BD equals to 1 units. Okay, this OB is equal to root 2. This is 1 unit. Now, this is 90 degree angle. Again, you can draw BD perpendicular with the help of protractor or compass. Now, join OD. Join OD. Again, on using Pythagoras theorem, OD square equals to OB square plus BD square. So, length of OD will be equals to square root of 3 on applying Pythagoras theorem. Now, to locate root 3 on the number line, okay, take a compass with center O and radius OD. Take a compass with center O and radius OD. Draw an arc intersecting the number line at a point Q. Suppose this is point Q. So, this point Q represents root 3 on number line. As you can see that root 3 will lie between 1 and 2. Also, root 2 lies between 1 and 2. Approximate value of root 2 is 1.414 and approximate value of root 3 is 1.732. So, it will be much closer to 2 than P. Okay. So, Q is the point which represents square root of 3 on the number line. Okay. Locating root 5 on number line. Now, using Pythagoras theorem, 5 can be written as 2 square plus 1 square. So, root 5 whole square equals to 2 square plus 1 square. So, we need a line of length 2 units and a perpendicular line of length 1 units. So, on the number line, take OA equals to 2 units and draw AB perpendicular to OA and length of AB equals to 1 unit. So, using Pythagoras theorem, length of OB will be square root of 5 units. Okay. Now, to represent root 5 on the number line, take a compass, place one end of compass on the O. Okay? Place one end of compass on O and extend the compass up to the length of OB. Place one end of compass at O and extend compass equal to the length of OB. That means center at O and radius equals to OB. Now draw an arc intersecting the number line at point P. Okay. Now with compass, okay, taking O as center and OB as radius, draw an arc intersecting number line at point P. Okay. Now see, with O as center, radius equals to OB, this P point also lies on the same circle. That is, the length of arc OB equals to length of arc OP equal to radius. So length of arc OB equals to root 5. So OP is also equals to radius. Then length of OP is also equals to root 5. That is why point P represents root 5 on the number line. Okay. I hope now it's clear to you.